Good morning, Standard 8. So far, we have completed the fundamental rights. Okay, fundamental rights are completed. Today, we are going to complete the chapter. In this, last class, we completed right to education and right to property. Now, today, we'll be doing check on arbitrary actions of the state. Okay. Check on arbitrary actions of the state. So here you see that the fundamental rights secured to the individual are in a nature of limitation or restrictions on arbitrary action of the state. Means the fundamental rights, the state government cannot make any law which affect our fundamental rights. So Article 13.2 declares that all laws are executive orders in force immediately before the commencement of the constitution, inconsistent with the fundamental rights, are void to extent of such an inconsistency. This article does provide for judicial review of all legislation in India. This article provides for judicial review means in case if our fundamental rights are affected by the parliament, like for example the parliament makes a law or any order by the executive which affect our fundamental right, then the Supreme Court has a power to provide for judicial review of all legislations in India. Okay, this is called judicial review. So however, the constitution has empowered the state to make valid exceptions to the right on the grounds such as security of the state, public order, public morality, etc. Okay, under this check on arbitrary actions of the state. The next we have restrictions imposed. Okay, what are the restrictions? This we have done before also, but it's a repetition once again. So what are the restriction imposed? You see, fundamental rights are not absolute. So we have some limitations, we have some restrictions which are imposed. Like fundamental rights can be suspended during the time of emergency, and this emergency is the national emergency. And I taught to you when the national emergency is called, in case if there is in case of war, external aggression or armed rebellion. So this emergency is called. So in case if there is an emergency, so the fundamental rights can be suspended during the time of emergency. Okay, it can be suspended for a temporary period. Now the second thing which you have to remember in the restrictions, that for the security of the state and national interest, reasonable restrictions on the fundamental rights can be imposed. Like parliament has the power to modify the application of fundamental rights to the members of the armed forces and the public forces or intelligence organization so as to ensure proper discharge of their duties. Okay. Then the third, I explained to you about the laws. The parliament has made certain laws. So there are some laws which restrict the use of these rights in a public interest. Which are the laws? I taught to you MISA, that is Maintenance of Internal Security Act, DIR, Defense of India's Rule, Preventive Detention Act, PDA, National Security Act, NDA, so here NSA, so Essential Service and Maintenance Act, ESMA. So these are the acts or the laws passed by the parliament to restrict our fundamental right. And why it is done? To safeguard the interest of the nation, but they curtail the use of the fundamental right. The next, suspension of fundamental right. Right now, I explained to you the fundamental rights can be suspended during the time of national emergency. Under which article this national emergency is called? Article 352. The president has the power to call for national emergency. And when the national emergency is called, the fundamental rights can be suspended. So here, when fundamental rights is suspended, like proclamation of such an emergency is made, the legislature is free to make any law, and executive has the liberty to take any action, even though it restricts the right to freedom of speech, expression, assembly, association, movement, residence, professions, or occupations. We cannot move to the Supreme Court, even though it affects, okay, our right to freedom. You cannot, because it is in our Article 352, when national emergency is called, it is suspended. The next we have fundamental duties. So altogether we have total 11 fundamental duties, and these fundamental duties, right, duties and rights go hand in hand. There can be no right in society where there are no duties. Okay, so to enjoy your fundamental rights, you have to perform certain duties. Okay, you have to perform certain duties to enjoy your fundamental rights. Okay, so these fundamental duties are added to the Constitution by 42nd Amendment Act 1976. Fundamental duties, and it is inserted in Part 4 of the Constitution. Then Article 51A of the Constitution states the following 10 duties of the citizen, and the 11th duty, Article 11th duty, was added by the Constitution in 86th Amendment Act 2002, 11th duty. Okay. Total 10 duties are there in Article 51A, and 11th duty clause AK was added by the Constitution under 86th Amendment Act 2002. Okay, so we have several fundamental duties. I'll just explain few fundamental duties. To abide by the Constitution and respect its ideal and institutions, the national flag and the national anthem. Then, to cherish and follow the noble ideals which inspired our national struggle for freedom. To uphold and protect the sovereignty, unity, and integrity of India. To defend the country and render national service when called upon to do so. To promote harmony and spirit of common brotherhood amongst all the people of India, transcending religious, linguistic, and religion or sectional diversities, to renounce practices derogatory to the dignity of women, to value and preserve the rich heritage of our composite culture. So like this, we have so many fundamental duties, and it goes side by side. We have to follow the fundamental duties to enjoy the fundamental rights. The last topic is importance of fundamental duties. So what are the importance of fundamental duties? To make the citizen aware of their social and economic obligations. To warn them to do and not to do certain things in the interest of their country, fellow, as citizen and themselves. Protect and awaken the people to their cultural heritage. To tame the unruly element in society, and to strengthen national harmony as they stir up patriotism. So these are the importance of fundamental duties which you have to learn. Okay, so today's class, we ended the chapter where you studied about check on arbitrary actions of the state. You studied restrictions imposed. You studied suspension of fundamental rights, fundamental duties you studied, and then the last you studied importance of the fundamental duties. Please learn it. Thank you.